And hey, welcome back to our program. I want to talk a little bit about this Stanford case that is dominating so much of the news in Louisiana that's affected so many people. If you're outside the listening area or outside of Louisiana, not aware of what's happening with the Stanford Group case, Alan Stanford has been arrested and charged with a multitude of crimes involving laundering money and selling CDs that were phony, scraping off funds, a whole litany of crimes, and I'm sure a lot more will be paid up listed in the weeks and months to come. But Louisiana was hard hit. Looks like Texas, Florida, and Louisiana were the greatest concentration of sales of these CDs. People were sold CDs down in a bank in the Bank of Antigua. They ended up having no value whatsoever. They were very attractive because they were 2 to 3 points higher than you could get if you went to your local bank or any other bank in the country. And so you can imagine that a lot of people flocked to getting the best return on these CDs. Some 1,700 people were affected in Louisiana, many in the Baton Rouge area with Exxon and other companies here who put their life savings in what they thought was a safe investment and something that they could use in later days as a way of helping them as they retired. Well, it turned out to be a fraud, and a lot of people have lost all their life savings. Very, very tragic to what's happened to them. And so it's the focus of a major investigation. Now, a lot of angry people are out there, obviously at the Stanford Group, at Alan Stanford, but just as much as the Securities and Exchange Commission, the Federal Commission, they say should have been giving proper oversight. You might read my column this week on my website, because I raised some questions that you're going to see some lawyers raise in the weeks and months to come, and that is, where was the state of Louisiana? There is an Office of Financial Institutions that is supposed to be the chief regulator of groups like Stanford. Stanford, by the way, is a trust. You know how you see on the front of banks and trusts? Well, you can also form just a trust that has limited obligations to maintain funds. It's not a bank. It's not a bank and trust. It's just a trust. Interestingly, there's only one trust authorized to do business in the state of Louisiana, and that's the Stanford Trust. No other trust is allowed to do business in the state of Louisiana. No one else has applied, I guess. And there's some limited authority of this trust, and nothing in the trust agreement or the laws of Louisiana allow a trust to go out and sell CDs to some Latin American bank. So why were they allowed to carry on like this? Where was the OFI, the Office of Financial Regulation, in terms of examining, monitoring, and allowing Stanford to do all that they did? And I would argue to you, as a former regulator, having been insurance commissioner and shutting down probably 75 to 100 companies, that there are certain obligations that regulators have in terms of coming in and seizing and shutting down companies that are not playing by the rules and that don't have the capital and surplus available. I did this, like I say, on many, many occasions. I think some 50 companies in the first year I was insurance commissioner alone. Office of Financial Regulation, OFI, has the authority to come and shut down and seize this trust and shut this operation down. And I think they should, quite frankly. If they would, in effect, go into a Louisiana court and put the Stanford Group into a Louisiana receivership, then a receiver could be appointed who could gather up all these funds in bank accounts in Louisiana, not let them be whiffed away over to Dallas or to New York or someplace else by a federal receiver. Keep them here for those in Louisiana that put the money in. And that hasn't been done, and that's puzzling to me. So there's one big mistake there. There's two mistakes. First, no regulation. Number two, improper not stepping in and seizing the company when it got so bad. Obviously, there was some real shenanigans going on. And the third problem, like I think OFI has, quite frankly, is its liability. You know, public officials have immunity, if you will. They can't be sued for doing their job. But if you look at the immunity statutes and you look at the cases with those statutes, it says that you can't be sued for maybe making mistakes or maybe doing a sloppy job, but you can be sued if you do nothing at all, if you just do not assert your obligation to perform and to regulate. And there's some pretty crafty lawyers in Louisiana. They're coming up with the theory that OFI made a huge mistake in not regulating and therefore are liable to be sued. There is a limit in Louisiana of $500,000, which means they can bring a lawsuit for up to that amount, up to $500,000. Well, if you take 1,700 claimants in Louisiana, just Louisiana claimants alone, multiply that times $500,000, you come up with $850 million, $850 million. And that's just Louisiana people. You might make the argument that if a Stanford office, say in Baton Rouge, was selling to clients in Texas or Arkansas or over in Mississippi, that those people might have a claim against OFI here in Louisiana. We could be talking about well over $1 billion to settle up these lawsuits involved. So Stanford is a big mess. So far, the anger has been directed at the SEC, the Securities and Exchange Commission, and to the Stanford Group itself, Alan Stanford, the founder of the group. But I think in the weeks to come, you're going to be some of that anger directed with legal backup towards the OFI, the Office of Financial Institutions. We'll keep you posted here on the show. Again, if you want to read the column that I wrote this week, go to my website, www.jimbrownla.com. That's jimbrownla.com. It's the lead article on my blog talking about this suit. You can go and read the column and see what you think. And then let me hear from you at jb@jimbrownla.com. Let me know your reaction to it. We'll certainly have a chance to talk about again here about this some more. We'll come back right after this break.